Hi and welcome back to Ultrasign, and once again with Andreas. And what do you have for us today?
Oh, today I was almost going to say as usual, but I have actually two electronic tracks today.
Okay.
Which is not maybe a big surprise when it comes to me. Or maybe just one, I don't know. But this one, I don't know much about this band, but I like it. It's very it's right up my alley. It's Project Pitchfork.
Okay. And this never heard of.
No, same here. But this is obviously in the electronic music kind of EBM world, well-known band. But I've missed them, so I found this and I really like it, and I also like this video. It's very dramatic. It's like my favorite thing in videos, which is the ocean.
Okay.
It's always dramatic, and it usually works to dramatize music. So I'm gonna find out more about this band, but now let's just play the song, I suppose.
Yeah, I just read a little bit about them, and they are from Germany.
Yeah, no surprise.
And they started 1989. So they have been around for a while, and they called synth rock dark wave, something like that.
I would probably say EBM dark wave.
Yeah,
but it's, you know, it is dark wave electronic, almost, you know, there's also a touch of industrial, and you can actually tell by the video that they have been around for a while. They look like they've been around, but they sound a bit angry and like German.
They sound German.
Yeah, I mean.
So what do you mean? We have something between Kraftwerk and Rammstein, or?
In a way, but in between Kraftwerk and Rammstein is dark wave. So that's
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let's find out what this is.
Yeah.
Project Pitchfork Rain. And do you have sound?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I forgot if I. Yeah. Okay. Anyhow.
Thank you.
Once again, you found something that I really like.
Oh, okay, good. Me too. I mean, it's amazing that you, I mean, you just come across new music and they have been around for a very long time.
Did you listen to anything from the older stuff? For this one was from the last album, I think.
Yeah, I suppose I would like the old stuff better, because in this track, I mean, I really like this.
But it's very modern and.
Well, they are trying to sound modern.
They do, but
I think older stuff, which I am going to check out soon, maybe tonight, I think it will sound more raw, because this, I mean, I like this, but I think it's probably a bit more raw in, let's say, early 90s, mid 90s, something like that.
Yeah, because this kind of music have changed, not so much in how they produce, but the sound quality and the computers and everything have been so good now. So it's so much easier to get clean sound and this dirtiness that you had in early 90 automatic in the sound in the Kraftwerk and stuff like that. It's...
Yeah, but I miss that dimension. Also, this is, as I told you before earlier, that I want to photograph with film.
Yeah.
Because it's something kind of rough-edged about it. And it's like, it was the same with how they produced music back then, because they didn't have all this fancy equipment, or they had the equipment but it couldn't do all this nice sounding stuff.
Yeah, they didn't have 100 channels for a guitar or for a drum. You had like one channel.
Yeah, they had in total 24.
Yeah.
And then you just have to make it work. And anyway, I like this.
Yeah, it was very nice, and I get what you mean with the German feeling, because there is a band that's quite big now, metallish band that called Lord of the Lost. If you know them,
no, but
it's a metal, but it sounds similar anyway, and then you have, like we said, Rammstein, you have others. They have some industrial sound. Yeah.
Yeah, they have a German sound somehow.
What do you call them? Blixa Bergul's band.
Einstein, the Neubauten.
Yeah.
I really like them. You just need to be patient.
Yeah, but they have some songs that get you direct, Garden and something like that. But
but it's also
some of their tracks are hard to like first time you listen to it.
Yeah, maybe ever. But you know, you have to be impressed by them because they just don't give a fuck. They just do. Okay, we want to do it like this. Okay, cool. Because they are actually cool people. I think Blixa is one of the coolest rock stars ever. He's like this mysterious thing.
Yeah, but he had, or his generation had a great impact of the sound of German industrial bands today. And you hear it here, and you hear it in other places. So
this also goes with the band DAF. Do you know them?
I can't I know them by name, but
it's like the godfathers of German kind of edgy synth.
I think it's like last week. You know, you can say a name and you can say a title, but then you have to play it for me. I'm like, aha!
Yeah, I will play it but, in another show, but yeah. It's actually amazing because that's really rough edge. I mean, it's so simple technology-wise. Maybe, you know, it's a couple of old school synthesizers with filters and a drum machine. And they sound very German. And I don't mean this in a negative way. It's just a special sound. And they influenced all the ones that came after.
Yeah.
So they had this gen, and also Kraftwerk, of course, but they were always very nice sounding.
Yeah, they were. They were quite pop, actually. And
yeah, but
many hits and... yeah,
it's still very influential.
Yes, of course.
That they built their own synthesizers. They were like engineers from a technical university, and they actually built what they are generating sound from, and that's very cool.
That's very cool, indeed. About Project Pitchfork, I see that they actually have been a supporter band for Rammstein, so...
Yeah, that's not a surprise.
Yeah. Well, I like this, and I hope you like it, and I hope you find out more about them and play more for us in the future.
Yeah, I will.
Perfect. See you in the next video.